Hello, 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 and welcome back to N Raghav TV for yet another video. This time, analyzing and reacting to Barcelona president Joan Laporta's quotes and his thoughts on the various topics such as Koeman, Messi's contract situation, Pep, the European Super League, and many more. Let's get started. My initial reaction to the press conference was quite positive. After so many years, Barca finally has such a vocal and open president, which was quite evident from the press conference. He was quite transparent, but at the same time, he did not reveal much information before anything was official. Now let's move on to the quotes. Joan Laporta's press conference. First of all, I think this was such a good move because there were so many reports and so many things going on at the club that this was quite necessary, and kudos to Laporta for that. So let's get started with first what he had to say about our short-term plans. We want to explain the short-term road plan because I've noticed that the rhythms these days are different. He talked about rhythm quite a lot in this press conference. We're finishing a project which hasn't worked. At this moment, we are starting a new project that will give a lot of Barca fans hope and joy. See, under Bartomeu, although we made so many signings and we made so many big money signings, but I feel that there was no plan on what we had to do and who was going to coach the club, and it was just a spur of the moment thing. But now I think that Laporta has come in. He had an half a year to clear out what the previous board was doing, and I feel now from the new season we will see what Laporta has planned for us. And he says that he wanted to present myself in front of the media to explain us. Yes, which I again, as I said, was such a good move. This is what I feel we have to focus here right now, because Laporta clearly says that there are no things, let me repeat, there are no things such as transitional projects. So Laporta, Barca, we have been struggling so many years, so many humiliations in the Champions League, although we have won quite a lot domestically, but still we haven't been the best of best in Europe. So this quote gives me a lot of positivity with Laporta, because he says there is no such thing as transitional projects, which means he wants to win right now. And I feel that's a big positive for us Barca fans. From then he moves on to Ronald Koeman, where he says that we already have told the coach at the end of the season that we would assess, and always with respect and admiration for Ronald Koeman, who still has a contract. So there was quite a bit of speculation going on about Ronald Koeman's future, with Laporta assessing many managerial options. I feel that was because I was Koeman out, but now that there were many reports coming out saying that we'll have to pay up Koeman about 13 million, so I think that's why many people were still Koeman in. But the above quote, which was the most important quote I feel of this entire press conference, which was there is no such things such as transitional projects. So I feel that Laporta, again, he wants to succeed now, so maybe if Koeman is not the right manager, he might not continue next season. So let's move on. I think he talks about Koeman ahead in the press conference. And he talks about Messi and Messi's future. He said that the new contract for Messi is going well, but it's not done yet. We hope that it will be accepted by the player. And our relationship is very good, and Messi loves Barcelona. That is no doubt. And I feel that we are edging closer and closer to Messi renewing and staying at Barca for next season. And talking about Messi staying at Barcelona, I feel one of the main reasons for Messi continuing is because of this. Next week, Laporta says that next week we'll talk about new additions to the team. Like many renowned journalists have confirmed that Sergio Aguero will sign for sure. Gini Wijnaldum also closing to a done deal. Eric Garcia also quite a done deal. And we are edging closer and closer to signing Memphis Depay. So that's, I think that next week will be a big, big one for Barca because they will be announcing many of their new signings. And yeah, let's see. Here he talks about the handball team. I don't think we are interested in that part. Let's move on to the most, one of the most interesting parts was the European Super League part, where he said that the European Super League was very advanced when he arrived. So this was not a Laporta decision for all those fans who were upset, including me, during the initial phase when ESL was announced, that we thought that Laporta had accepted the deal, but no, it was not Laporta. European Super League was very advanced when he arrived, and for Barca it was important to be involved because you can never be standing on the sidelines when it comes to new movements in the world of football. I think for Barca and Real Madrid, it was more of a desperate move rather than a money move, because ahead in the press conference he talks about how the English clubs have they can pump in money and they can get more revenue into the club. But for clubs like Barca, which are people run, these are the ways we can earn money. So that's what he said, that we came to a conclusion that we wanted to be involved in the European Super League, but we reserved our place. This club belongs to the socios, and we want to discuss it with them. So that's what he has said, that we'll be discussing this with the socios, and they will take a decision on whether they will be continuing with ESL or not. Moving on, where Laporta talks about other problems. He says that even the smaller clubs are facing problems, so we want to advance the point, and Barca is always about dialogue. He says that he is ready to speak with the higher heads of UEFA and FIFA, but he is not willing to apologize, which he says ahead. Laporta, he says he can't be precise financially because they're still under audit, and this is again one of the most important things, which is on June the 20th there'll be an assembly meeting. Things are emerging that we will have to solve. Some are worrying, others surprising. So again, he's hinted some things, but he has not quite told us openly what the things are. But he has confirmed that there will be an assembly meeting on June 20th. Now moving on, where questions were asked, message to the socios, Laporta says there's patience and optimism. That's what we have been waiting for so many years, and he has promised us the next season will be successful. So again, quite hinting at maybe changes coming soon or maybe not. Let's see. He talks about Johan Cruyff and how he has influenced Barca, not only in the first team but a club as a whole. We are Cruyffistas in all sections, he says. Yes, brave and win by playing well. Then he continues talking about the financial situation, where he says that the situation is very, very delicate, and that we are in big losses and huge debt. So everything we do will be, everything that Barca do have to be assessed quite carefully. Moving on to where he talks about now Ronald Koeman. He said we'll sit down with Koeman next week and we'll finish defining all the aspects and we will decide together. We are evaluating everything that has been done this season. Now this is where I feel, although quite many reports since the last 1 week have been suggesting, where reports have said that the signings are what Ronald Koeman wanted, like the signing of Memphis Depay, which is almost done, Gini Wijnaldum, were all signings that Ronald Koeman wanted. So the media tried to indicate that Komen was staying, but in the past 48 hours few interesting things have happened. So let's see. He says that we didn't sign Komen. Again, this is what is bothering me now, because Ronald Koeman, I think he has done decently well, but I think sacking him, he will feel very bad. But if we have to move ahead, I think the sacking is very imminent. So let's see what Laporta had to say about Koeman. He says, we didn't sign Koeman. That's the key word here. That is, we didn't sign Koeman. We need these conversations with him to verify that we want the same at Barca. We speak very clearly, but with respect and admiration. So as I said previously, where Laporta said that next season will be successful and there is no such season called transition, but if you hear Ronald Koeman in a few press conferences has said that we are in transition. So again, slightly indicating that Koeman might not continue next season. So he talks about Ronald Koeman going to hospital. See, this is where things go interesting, because here Laporta says that yesterday Koeman gave us a worrying fear. He had to go to the hospital, but luckily everything is okay. I told him to calm down and take it easy. But if we look at reports which emerged, where Fabrizio Romano had tweeted a few hours ago, just before recording, that just a second, let me open it up. Yeah, this is what Koeman's agency had tweeted and deleted. So Ronald Koeman's agency, disappointed after Laporta's statements in today's press conference, said, imagine I want to marry you, but I have doubts. Give me 2 weeks to find a better partner. If I can't, the right person, we will get married away. So that's quite interesting. Again, showing rifts between Laporta and Koeman. Then he's asked about whether Xavi will come in as a coach. Again, he says that Xavi, that we have again, one more thing which he keeps talking about in this press conference was that Ronald Koeman has a contract and we quite respect Koeman. See, even for me as a Barca fan, even from a fan perspective, everybody respects Ronald Koeman, because it's not easy to pick up a team from losing 8-2 and then we go into a season where he gets very little signings. The problem was that we expected very less, but then when we started pushing and when it mattered the most, we crumbled. So that's the problem that we had, that I especially had with Ronald Koeman, that in a game against Granada, where we could have easily won and gone top of La Liga and we could have been competing for La Liga, but we bottled that one game, and since that one game we had a very, very poor ending to the season. So yeah, that's why I feel that we should respectfully sack Koeman and let him know that we want to move forward. So let's get going with the press conference. Again with Xavi, he says that he's a good friend, and again he talks about Koeman and does not want to force him out. And Messi, and about, again, when asked about Messi, he says that he's excited by the project and he's moderately optimistic. He doesn't, again, showing transparency, but he's not revealing 100% information on whether Messi is renewing or not. Then people asked about the rumors of Pep Guardiola returning. See, there isn't much into this rumor. I would say it's just a dream signing, as you can see where it says that Laporta, Guardiola is my dream. Here, then I feel this reply was quite apt, where he said that now I'm not here to talk about dreams, I'm here to talk about realities. And he wishes Pep Guardiola all the best for the Champions League final, which is upcoming. And again, he says that he's a great friend. And he says, yes, Koeman is the right profile for the manager. Again, see, he's hinting 50-50 here, because even I am not quite sure if Ronald Koeman will continue. But again, he's seesawing on his on Ronald Koeman. Then he talks that wage bill must be adjusted. Yes. Then he talks about Espai Barça, which is the Barcelona stadium reconstructions, which, well, I don't know what Bartomeu did with this project. He completely ruined it. And now Laporta said that the audit will determine the final budget and there will be improvement in a plan with the city council and they will get going with it. See, again, when he's asked about Ronald Koeman, he was critical initially. Then now he's saying that, yes, it can work. That's the key here, which is it can work. Our relationship is very good and clear. Again, stating in this video that Laporta is hinting 50-50 on Ronald Koeman, and again, he's giving information, but he's not revealing too much. I'm sorry if I'm repeating the same thing again and again, but it's quite important, you know. Then he was asked about this situation in 2003 and 8 where Frank Rijkaard was sacked and Pep Guardiola came into the club. He says that, yes, we have experience, but the situation is different from 2003 and 2008, but the principles will remain the same. Then again, he talks about Messi being comfortable at Barcelona, and they asked what is different from what has changed since the Burofax, Messi sent the Burofax, and this statement was quite commanding, which is, he said, well, now I am the president and I think Leo likes that. So now Laporta clearly showing domination, and that, you know, the kind of president we needed to lead our club ahead. Then he talks about Seferin and how that there's no justification for UEFA penalizing Barcelona. And again, he says that we will go to the court of arbitration of sports and we will surely win. But I don't think there is much to go into this. I think this dispute will be dealt in internally. And let's see what he has to say. Then Laporta says that there are a lot, when asked about investors, he said that there are a lot of investors who are quite keen to work with the club, and they will receive offers every day. That and he has said, again, one of the most important parts, I am optimistic that in 2 seasons that the club will be healthy again. And he said, and to conclude, he said that we will have a very competitive team for next season. So my final reaction to the press conference is that, as I said earlier, that I was quite happy that he came out and addressed all the issues that were going on in the club, and he has given certain guarantees, also not guaranteeing certain things like Ronald Koeman's future and he said players coming in, and he said there is no transition season, but we've heard Koeman say again and again about transitional seasons. So again, let's wait and see in the upcoming few weeks whether Ronald Koeman continues as Barcelona coach, and let's see how competitive of a squad that Laporta is building with such a delicate financial situation. So guys, this was a bit of a podcast type of a video. So if you like the video, do like and consider subscribing to the channel for more such content. Also, I have created a Discord server. Do join in. Let me know your thoughts both in the Discord server and in the comment section down below. All my links in the description. And until next time, as always, Visca El Barça.